Hey guys! So, it's been a really long time since I talked to anyone. So, disregard my room because it's a mess right now, because I'm like trying to get my stuff together to move and stuff. We're signing the lease tomorrow at 11:30, so I don't know like if we're gonna have the opportunity to go in it. If we do, I'll make another video. Basically, we're looking at this one apartment for $400, and then, it was okay, but like we wouldn't have had as much privacy as this other one we found for $600. So our realtor offered us the entire downstairs for $650 with water and sewage included. So we essentially have two apartments. We have a huge kitchen, and then we have like a microscopic kitchen. And we have two bathrooms and like four bedrooms. And our living room has a fireplace, but we can't use it because we're renting. And then it has like this sunroom that's awesome, and I want to turn it into my study, but the guys probably want me to get a jam room or something manly. But I'm really excited, but I need to start packing and stuff, which I don't really have time to do. I'm gonna have to find time somewhere though. So South Africa, it's really hard to explain in like 25 words or less, but we spent the first three, after like 20 hours of airports and layovers, we spent the first 3 days in Cape Town, which is really modern, more modern than Europe. In my opinion, the music was very modern, and it was really awesome. And we went to Robben Island, where a lot of apartheid prisoners were kept, including Nelson Mandela, for 28 years. And then we went to the waterfront, we went to a jazz club, we did a walking tour, we ate at like a Cape Malay restaurant. We went to Cape Point, which is the lowest point of South Africa, where the Indian Ocean and the Atlantic Ocean meet, which was really cool. And then we spent 2 days in East London, well, a day and a half. Two nights and about a day and a half, and we went to a safari, which is really awesome to see like animals out in the wild and not in giant cages. So we saw giraffes and zebras and white lions, which they breed at Inkankwezi. We spent the last 5 days in the village, which was really awesome and like the most beautiful scenery I've ever seen before. And then we got to interact with a lot of the local people. We got to barter at some markets, so I got a lot of really cool souvenirs. And that mug, which you probably can't see, I got there. And then we pretty much came back. We spent a day in Johannesburg. And we went to the Apartheid Museum. And, like, I'm just fascinated by apartheid now. The Apartheid Museum was really cool because it had a lot of like video footage, but pictures of like what exactly was going on during apartheid. And I was really interested in it from like a historical perspective, and it was just really interesting. I don't know why I was interested. I mean, I guess I'm just interested in issues of like race and class and stuff in general. But I thought it was really cool. So I got a really cool T-shirt at the Apartheid Museum, which I haven't worn yet because it's freezing.
Your door. I hate to wake you up to say goodbye, but the dawn is breaking, it's early morn. The taxi's waiting, he's blowing his horn. Already I'm so lonesome, I could die. So kiss me and smile for me. Tell
I just put up my new Hitchner posters that look like this. So, this is a very busy semester with my Hitchner and Vagina Monologue, which is somebody, Liz Britton, which we all know, she decided that she was going to drop out this week. The show's in 3 weeks, so I have to do her part now because I can't recast. And I'm just really pissed about it, and I'm really mad that she's just like, oh, I just took on too much and I didn't realize. Well, freaking figure out your schedule early in that. Don't be 3 weeks into rehearsals and then be like, oh, I can't do it now. I was so angry, because I had two people drop out over Christmas break as well. There's just one more person that I had to, like, redo things for. And I had just sent in the t-shirt design, so I had to email him and tell him not to do the screen prints yet because I had to take her name off the shirts. So I just, like, want to strangle her right now. And then, just, like, everything for that is just... I mean, I'm in, like, rehearsals for over 10 hours a week as it is, and, like, it's just stressful, and I'm not really getting a lot of help, and then because Tirsa completely depleted our budget, I don't have any money to do anything, so I'm trying to, like, work around that, too, like, how I'm supposed to get certain things if I don't have any money, and I don't have the money to be shelling it out and not getting paid back, especially with getting the apartment and stuff, so I'm really annoyed about that. And then I'm also really stressed about grad school because I've heard a bunch of people that apply to Ohio State that I've already heard, and I know people who have heard from Penn State and all these places I've applied, and I haven't heard anything from anyone. So the only place I heard from, of course, was the University of Washington, and the only reason I applied there was because they were this stretch school that, like, I just knew I wasn't going to get into. They only accept, like, 3 people into the Women's Studies program a year because it's just extremely competitive. And I'm only a minor. I don't even have a major, so I didn't even expect at all to, like, hear anything. And they emailed me saying, like, I was in the final. I was, like, one of the final people that they were considering for one of the 3 positions. However, don't worry, because I screwed up. I was freaking out for multiple hours, like, what the heck am I going to do if I get accepted there? Like, it's how would somebody turn that down? Like, it's the most amazing opportunity ever. It's, like, the second best women's studies program in the country. Like, but, like, they misinterpreted my purpose, my statement of purpose, and they thought that I had already written my thesis about women in heavy metal, and so they requested that I send it to them. And I had to respond with, like, it's not really written yet. I was planning on doing it in grad school, but I have all these other awesome papers. If you'd like to review, you can. And they were kind of just like, so it's not written? And I was like, no. And then I really haven't heard anything. So, I mean, I don't have to worry. I'm probably not getting in, but it was just, like, an honor to, like, know that I was considered in the last 3, which I don't understand because that's the freaking hardest school I applied to, and I found out I'm in the final running in that school, and no one else has sent me fucking anything, and I'm really annoyed, and everyone knows, like, the Katie Salvo issue, which hasn't been too bad other than that. She's, like, trying to get with Michelle, who's, like, one of my best friends, and it's really obnoxious because, I don't know, it just is frustrating because I know why she's doing it, and... So, yeah, so she pretty much took Michelle. I don't see Michelle that much anymore. They're, like, not together or anything, but they're, like, together a lot. And I just don't feel very comfortable with it. So, like, I don't really see them much. And then she found out that she got accepted for the straight to PhD program in Women's Studies and History at Penn State with 5 of her 6 years fully paid for. And I'm so angry and jealous. Like, I was, like, crying one night because it pissed me off. Like, she's a horrible person. She doesn't even want to go there. Like, that's her number 7, like, in her list, in her room. Like, because I asked her if that was her first, and she's like, no, I don't, like, even want to go there. That's, like, my last choice, and that's, like, my first choice, and they haven't even contacted me at all, like, saying, oh, you know, we'd be interested in hearing more about you or anything. So I'm, like, freaking out, and I'm really annoyed, but, so assuming I don't get, like, anywhere really paid for me, I'm probably just gonna go to Lockhaven, and, so if that happens, I'm trying to get, like, a full-time job at SU for next year. I've been, like, sending emails out, trying to get people to be like, oh, yeah, so Dina at the CDSJ, because that's one of the departments I'm really, like, close with, emailed her about the possibility, because they don't have an administrative assistant, and they desperately need one. So she emailed me back today and said that she's been trying for a year, but, like, we should really talk, because she'd love to have me be their administrative assistant next year and stuff. So if I don't get, like, if Penn State isn't going to pay for me to go there, because that's the only way I'd be able to go there, even though it is my first choice, then I'll probably just go to Lockhaven and do the program mostly online, and then work full-time at SU. That's my, like, my dream if Penn State doesn't pay for it. That'd also be nice because I'd have a full-time incoming going in income coming in while still, like, attending school. And I, like, really enjoy online classes. I know some people don't, but I really like online classes, so that'd be, like, a really nice option for me. But, yeah, it all depends on, like, if I ever hear from Penn State or whatever. So, that's pretty much my life. This is probably long because I had a lot to talk about, and I kind of didn't even say a lot of what I probably still could talk about. But if you guys are, like, have the opportunity, I really wish you'd come home this weekend. GSA is having a tracks party, and Laura, your mom's very excited, and we're all very excited. Like, she's awesome. Like, she found all this, like, glitter makeup, and we're gonna have, like, this glitter station and stuff. And she's like, I feel like Tirsa probably thinks I'm creepy. And I was like, no, we think it's awesome. But she doesn't believe us. But, so that's Saturday night, but so is Kyle's Super Bowl Eve party. So I'm gonna, like, somehow try to go to both, but I also kind of want to drink, so I don't, like, you can't really go to track sober. Like, it's just not that much fun. Although it might be because, like, all my friends will probably be sober too. So I'm debating whether I want to do that first and be sober and then go over to Kyle's really late. But I'm afraid that by the time I get to Kyle's, like, everyone is going to be, like, smashed and obnoxious, and I'm not going to want to drink. So, I don't know. I don't really know what I'm doing. I'll figure it out at some point. But, yeah. We have the Regina Mala's photo shoot this weekend, so everyone gets black and white pictures that, like, you can't really see your face, and they're usually nude, and I've been debating forever what I wanted to do, but I think that I'm gonna, like, get, like, just, like, my upper chest, and I'm probably gonna wear a bra, and then in black paint I'm gonna, like, write freedom across my chest, and I'm really excited because the person who's taking our picture is incredible. Like, I don't know if you guys are friends with Maxine on Facebook, but her name's Mandy, and she's the one who did her lit pictures that she has up, and she took the picture of Kyle and Maxine. Like, she's an awesome photographer. She's actually probably better than Kelly, but don't tell her I said that. And so I'm really excited to see, like, everyone's photos from the photo shoot and stuff so that I can make advertisements and then the playbill and then everything else. But that's pretty much it. Oh, the, like, head of student activities, Jamel, he, like, contacted me and wants me to organize, like, all of Women's History Month at SU. Like, he wants me to plan, like, 11 events for March, and I'm like, a little more notice would have been nice, because in the original email he made it sound like he was gonna help a lot, and then in the second email it was like, oh yeah, well, we should meet at some point to discuss it, like, basically run with it and plan everything, and then I'm gonna attach student activity's name on it, and that kind of rubbed me the wrong way, because I don't really have time to be planning, like, 10 events in March on top of Vagina Mala at the end of this month, and